This morning at 10 o'clock, there was a funeral for Ronald Bonnet, probably one of a couple funerals here in Columbia. Not many people probably pay attention to this funeral except for the family and friends of Mr. Bonnet. But I think it's a very significant funeral because it indicates the problem that we've got in our community. See, Mr. Bonnet was a working man, was a painter, lived in apartments off of Beatty Road. A couple weeks ago on Friday night, he'd gotten off work, went home, went to throw the trash away, and got caught in the crossfire of two rival gangs shooting each other. And Mr. Bonnet died. And today is his funeral. And not only is his family going to be sad, but I think all of us should be sad, because this is the second time this year that we've had someone shot and killed like this. Back in August, Nakia Scott was killed, just being in her apartment. We've got too many young people out here with guns who just do not care. Do not care about anybody's life. They don't care what happens when they start shooting these guns. In this incident, we had at least 25 rounds that were fired in an apartment complex. Not only was Mr. Bonnet killed, but we had three cars, two occupied apartments that bullets went into, too. You know, it's sad that we lost Mr. Bonnet, but it could have been worse because of the people shooting just did not care where those bullets went and who was injured. They did not care about innocent people that could have died like Mr. Bonnet. We've arrested Daquan King, Elijah Gilmore, and Messiah Cornish, 17 and 18 years old. All three of them are charged with murder and the death of Mr. Bonnet. I think it's so ironic that two of these young men's names came from the Bible. I don't think there was a whole lot of Christianity going on that night when they were out there shooting in that apartment complex and not caring about what their bullets did. Two rival gangs that thought they could go out here and just do what they want to. Sad. It's sad that I have to stand here and talk about that. Sad that we've got such a problem in our community. And I hope that the death of Mr. Bonnet and Ms. Scott will be a wake-up call for this community, that we've got a community problem. It's not a law enforcement problem. We're locking people up. We're getting guns off the street. This is a community problem that exists within the Midlands, with young people with guns who just do not care. And I'll go all the way back to April 24th when Chief Holbrook and I created a task force to address this issue. Since April 24th, the Richland County Sheriff's Department has seized 553 guns. That's not hunting guns that people out here are using. These are illegal guns that are out here on our street. Those 553, 113 have been stolen. Just like four of the guns that were recovered in Mr. Bonnet's death, two of those guns were stolen also. People are still not securing their weapons. They're leaving them in their vehicles. The vehicle's unlocked and they're getting stolen. And then they end up in the hands of these punks that go out here and take people's lives. You know, we can stop that by not leaving our guns in our cars, keeping our cars locked at all times. But we've got to address this overall problem that we've got with young people with guns who just don't care. And these three here, I think, indicative of the problem that we've got in our community. You know, we're weeping with Mr. Bonnet's family today because he was an innocent person. Just an innocent person, just like all of us who are in this room, who are watching this, who could have just went out and threw their trash away. And their life was taken because people who just don't care. We're going to continue with our task force. We're going to continue to focus on those in our community who do things like this. Now, not only did Mr. Bonnet lose his life, but these three young people, one 17, two 18-year-olds, they've basically lost their lives too. This is four lives that are gone. Three in prison, one of them in the cemetery, and their families are going to cry for all four of them. But we've got to do something about young kids with guns, and we've got to do it as a community, not just law enforcement, not just the church, not just the school, but as a community. This is a community problem that we're going to address. Questions?
Did all three live in that complex where the shooting happened?
No, they didn't live there. And that's what we see with Miss Scott getting killed also. It wasn't people who lived there. It's just people who show up there and decide they're going to have a gunfight. And that's what happened at this apartment with Mr. Bonnet.
Any reason why they chose that apartment complex?
No, that's just a place that I think that the greed that they would meet at, or, you know, they came upon each other.
What are the names of the gangs that you all are looking at?
We're not going to identify the gangs. We're not going to give them any credibility whatsoever, so we're not going to name them.
Were these three in different gangs, or are they all part of one
team? No, it's two teams. And for being simple, we call them Team A and Team B. And you got some on Team A, you got some on Team B, and they're engaged in that shootout.
Do these gangs and the gang shootings have any relation to that almost 2-year-old and his father that was shot and killed on that same street?
We're still working that case and got some very good active leads, so we will solve that case also. There's no doubt in my mind that that case is also going to be solved.
What's the community need to do to help curb this? Do they see something, say something, or parents see their kids? What needs to be done, and how, community's helped out before. What more needs to be done now?
Well, parents need to get involved. We need to teach our kids at an early age, about gang activity and violence. Schools need to be involved. Churches need to be involved. Everybody needs involved. But it starts at a home. I imagine when these two were named by their parents, names that came from the Bible, I don't think the parents had any idea that, at that time, where their child would end up being. So it's a process. It starts at the home, and then it just goes through all of us. That's why it's a community problem. People want to say it's a law enforcement problem. It's not. It's a community problem when you get to where we're at now and the number that we have and the amount of guns we have on the street. But it's not having a conscience and not caring. When you're shooting multiple times in a crowded area and you don't care where those bullets are going, you have total disregard for life. Total.
Are you seeking more suspects in the case, or are these three yet?
We're continuing. There may be other people arrested. Everybody who was there and everybody who knew what was going on, everybody that was part of that shooting is going to be charged. That's something that, we're doing, that we're not going to let anybody escape free and just think that they can be part of this. And, they might not have pulled a trigger or their gun might not have hit anybody, but if they're there and they're involved, they're going to be charged.
What is your message to people watching this, thinking about a task as mundane as taking your trash out, not even expecting something like this to happen? Obviously, you don't want to incite panic, but what is your message to the community? Because normally you don't think twice about doing something like that.
Get mad and get sad. Be sad that it happened, but get mad that we need to do something about it. And that don't think that it can't happen to you. Miss Scott in her apartment. Mr. Bonnet taking the trash out. So you can't think it can't happen to you, and that's why everybody's got to be involved in it. That's why it's a team effort in solving this issue that we've got going on. But I don't think people think it's just Richland County, the city of Columbia. It's a nationwide problem. But these are individuals that we've lost here. That's the ones we need to care about, and we need to do something about it. Columbia's different. Columbia's better than this.
I know when we were talking to people in the neighborhood from that little boy being shot with his father, people were saying this is a neighborhood where gangs are very present, and they're afraid to even talk to us about whether or not it could be gang-related, or just about the situation as a whole. What would you say to community members to make sure that they feel comfortable enough and not have to be afraid of these gangs in their neighborhoods?
Work with us. Our gang unit's there. Our uniformed deputies are there. We're there. They can trust us. We're not going to let anybody know when people talk to us and tell us stuff. You can call in 911, and you don't have to give your name. Just give us the information. When you see, some gang activity, you see something that's suspicious or something that scares you, call. We're going to respond. And that's where it's going to take everybody. You can't turn your head and ignore it and think something might not happen. You know, it did. We saw that on October 26th, that Friday night. We saw what could happen.
You talked about the task force. I know that's been going on since this past spring. You talked about the number of guns that have been recovered. Is that a downward trend? Is it level? Is it increasing despite the task force?
We still got too many guns. We're still getting guns. Yeah. One thing that the task force has been successful at, you know, not only just seizing a large amount of guns and getting them off the street, but identifying those that are in gangs that are out here preying on our communities, and we're going after them. And you know, for a better term, we've created a list of people, the worst of the worst, and we've arrested quite a few. We have some more to go, and we're going to continue. That's why this task force is continuing the way it is. It's strong, and we're going to make sure it continues to be strong, but we need the help of the community. All right, thank you all.